So you're going to be faced throughout your career with a lot of ethical problems. And there is a very simple thing, again, this father taught me, to determine whether or not you've got an ethical problem. I started practicing law, I'd say, Dad, these people come to me and they want me to do this. And should I do it? My father was great for short answers and short solutions. Very simple. Just ask yourself, would you want what you're doing to be on the front page of the Los Angeles Times? If so, you don't need to write it down, it's in the book. It doesn't matter. You're comfortable with everybody knowing about the full circumstances of what you're doing. It's all right. You don't need to pay any attention to what other people tell you about whether it's fair or right to do it or not. On the other hand, if you have any question about other people knowing about it, then pass me by. It saved me from a lot of trouble over the years. I was involved in a number of situations where there was a question, should I go on the board of this company? I was on the board once of a bank, and I was to go on the board. So I sold the bank, and I was the chairman of the bank that was being sold. And the tradition was when this bank bought another bank, the chairman of the selling bank became a director of the bank. My law partner was very happy because it was the second biggest bank state at the time. Then it went bankrupt. So they were urging me, well, like, you're going to go on the board, we'll get all these clients and everything. And I looked at the financial statement and saw in one of the footnotes that the principal stockholder of the bank was the borrower at 40% of the loans of the bank's assets. And I said to the president of the bank, you better not put me on the board because I'll object to the key stockholder borrowing that much money from the bank. I said, I'll have to protect myself. I'll have to put that in the record every time there's a meeting that I've objected to this situation. So choose somebody else. That guy who went on that board, this was 40 years ago, spent $300,000 in defending himself when the bank went bankrupt. It's not difficult, if you do your homework, to find out what's going on. Always read the footnotes in the financial statement. That's where the answers are. The numbers themselves are not very good. It's the footnotes that tell you what's going on. And many times these large companies on the stock exchange that go broke, some of you are reading, you can read later, close the book. It'll only take you a half an hour to read that, basically. You don't need to do it now. So when you look at financial statements, you don't glance at them. You read them all the way through, and particularly the footnotes. How many people read The Motley Fool? They're familiar with it. Okay. Motley Fool is an advisory column or blog on the stock market. And I remember when, you may have heard of this, when Enron collapsed. And in The Motley Fool, these guys who were real experts, paid a lot of money for giving their advice, said, we admit we made a mistake. If we'd read the footnotes, we would have known what was going to happen. So that is, pay attention to the details. You know, they're all there.